I was sitting in the kitchen. The dogs were playing on the lawn. The postman comes with a card from Greenland. My friends are pictured on the ice cap edge. Ollie's wearing Viking's horns on his head. And Priska's wearing plaits. They finally got there with a rickshaw. But now they got four huskies and a sledge. This crazy journey started 20 years ago, while Ollie wandered India in search of a quest. He had a steamy affair with his cousin. So high on love, they conceived of a wild plan. He commissioned a bicycle rickshaw with all the frills, and installed a little engine to help them up the hills. They left sultry Madras like a psychedelic caravan. Kids running behind the Odyssey that then ran and ran. Strange forms of travel are dancing lessons from the gods. Thus speak the English eccentric with a zany grin, while stoned at a bar in Khartoum. He's explorer, the alchemist and the fool, living by his wits and ingenious charm. Watched by observers and friends, like some weird show that never ends. Bumping along the tracks of India was no mean feat, but they dozed under banyan trees to avoid the midday heat. They chanted in the temples and ate with sadhus, made love under the stars. They bustled in the markets, they drank in the smells, the color and the sounds. Made adjustments to the rickshaw and rearranged the baggage. They hustled with the traders and learned the language. Finally rolled into Bombay looking wild-eyed and savage. They shopped and languished in the flesh pots of the city. Had a blazing row when Ollie chatted up the hookers. Before too long he found some shipping bookers. Took the rickshaw in pieces and packed it into boxes. They shipped the rickshaw next day. Africa was the destination. Departed one more time and took the plane to Sudan. Took a truck to the Red Sea and arrived to meet the boat. Rebuilt the rickshaw, blessed the rite of passage with a company of goats. Strange forms of travel are dancing lessons from the gods. Thus spake the English eccentric with a zany grin, was stoned in a bar in Khartoum. He's explorer, the alchemist and the fool, living by his wits and ingenious charm. Watched by observers and friends, like some weird show that never ends. In 83 I met Ollie, he was driving a dump truck. I was learning theodolite, we were both in construction. We were strangers in a strange land, but felt recognition. We moved to a commune near the Nile with a garden. Ollie fell in love with a Sudanese girl called Saham. Intoxication took place in the souks of Omdurman. Soon they got married, the ceremony was Islamic. The music was frenzied, the guests were ecstatic. The fateful day arrived when he told her, we'll be leaving on the rickshaw to Egypt. Saham accepted her fate and they loaded supplies. They meandered the Nile, going deep in the desert. Ollie studied the river and contrived an odd dream. Stripped the wheels off the rickshaw and fixed on paddles. Built a raft underneath and launched into the stream. The rapids nearly drowned him, Saham let out a scream. Weeks later they came to the temples of Egypt. In Cairo they sampled the opium dens. In the chaos of excess into France. In London, celebrations flared up with his friends. Next year he embarked on some African jaunts, but India lured him back and he fell for a girl in Bombay. He stopped to write and reflect on the rickshaw traveler's key to the world. I lost touch for some time till he wrote from New Orleans. Spoke of a girl called Prisca, she was an architect. They got married and came back to England. Lived in the urban bothy with a trapdoor entrance. They came to roam the hills with me and played mad games and frolicked with the kids. Angels up above.